Welcome to another Elishop video. Today we're comparing two budget oscilloscopes, the Fnirsi 1013D and the Owon HDS242S. Both oscilloscopes are designed for portability in a similar price category. We'll go over the features, strengths and limitations to help you decide which one suits your needs best. Budget oscilloscopes are great for hobbyists, students, and technicians who need a portable and affordable option. Owon is a well-known brand with budget-friendly models, while Fnirsi is a newcomer offering extremely low prices. But how do they compare in practical use? Let's have a first look at both devices. The Owon HDS242S is a handheld oscilloscope with multiple functions. It's part of Owon's HDS200 series, which includes compact battery-powered oscilloscopes. This device functions as an oscilloscope, multimeter and function generator. The built-in multimeter is useful, but does not fully replace a dedicated multimeter. A cheap basic multimeter, like a Unity 139A, is more convenient to use and offers more features. In this video, we will therefore focus on the oscilloscope features. Its compact size makes it easy to store with other tools, and it comes with a carrying case for added convenience. The Owon uses replaceable 18650 batteries, rechargeable via USB-C for easy charging with a standard charger. This Owon portable oscilloscope features a button-based interface, without a touchscreen and without rotary knobs. Therefore, it's harder to operate this Owon scope than scopes which offer a touchscreen or rotary knobs. I will give you a quick demonstration. The trigger has a button and can be moved using the arrow keys. This allows for basic navigation and adjustments. Now, let's take a look at the measurement options. This scope features triggering with only edge detection, multiple trigger modes, and adjustable trigger level and coupling. This ensures precise capture of both continuous and one-time events for basic waveform analysis. Changing the time base is very straightforward. Press HOR and use the up and down arrows. Next, look at placing cursors. To access the cursor measurement, you need to first select measure/range. Next, press the cursor button to open the cursor options. Here you can choose from different measurement types. Now, let's select time as an example. Now you can move the cursor using the arrow keys to measure specific points on the waveform. Now, one limitation of this system is that all cursor movements rely solely on button functions, which can be a bit tiring. The Owon has a built-in function generator that allows you to generate different types of basic waveforms, including sine, square, ramp, pulse, and custom arbitrary waveforms. It is useful for basic tasks, but is not as capable as a standalone unit. The Fnirsi 1013D is built around a touchscreen interface, offering several key benefits. The large touchscreen is easy to read and navigate, relying entirely on touch controls without any physical buttons. It has good responsiveness and works well for basic functions. All essential settings are accessible with just a few taps. Menu buttons are small and text is large, which results in short text. Voltage is, for example, V, and time is T, but overall operation is straightforward and efficient. Let's start with the cursor functionality and measurements. Look at how smoothly I can position the cursors. This is much more easier than the Owon. Having a touchscreen for this just makes sense. Changing the time base took some time to figure out. It's not very intuitive. You have to tap on the sides of the screen to adjust it. Without reading the manual, you will never have guessed this. Now let's look at the trigger function. The trigger button is a bit hidden in the interface, but once found, it allows you to fine-tune the trigger level and mode. Setting it up is a bit clunky compared to the dedicated hardware buttons, but it gets the job done. Let's talk about bandwidth and when it matters. Bandwidth plays a crucial role in oscilloscope performance, but how much do you really need? These budget scopes have certain limitations, so it's important to set the right expectations. For automotive applications, most signals stay below 1 MHz. In hobbyist projects like Arduino projects, you can run into signals up to 10 MHz. If such a signal is a square wave, a 10 MHz signal has harmonics reaching up to 50 MHz. Understanding these factors helps you choose the right oscilloscopes for your needs. So both the Owon and the Fnirsi offer enough bandwidth for automotive and hobbyist usage. The Owon is also available with a higher bandwidth of 70 MHz, which you could consider. There is one caveat with the Fnirsi bandwidth, however. Fnirsi claims a 100 MHz bandwidth, but in reality, performance is closer to 20 MHz. Dave Jones from EVblog tested this and made a video about it. Dave shows in his video that the Fnirsi bandwidth is closer to 20 MHz than to 100 MHz. The sample rate is unknown, but definitely not 1 gig sample per second. Artifacts of aliasing are often visible. Dave also shows that the vertical accuracy of the scope is not great, so you cannot use the Fnirsi for accurate measurements. It's only suitable to evaluate the shape and approximate measurements of signals. Owon offers a solid 40 MHz bandwidth, making it more reliable for mid-range signals. Here is where these budget scopes differ. The Fnirsi 1013D relies entirely on the touchscreen interface, making navigation and cursor placements much easier compared to the Owon, which uses a button-based interface without a touchscreen or rotary knobs. The Owon includes a built-in function generator, allowing users to generate basic waveforms. The Fnirsi does not have this feature. When it comes to bandwidth, the Owon offers a reliable 40 MHz. The Fnirsi is advertised as having 100 MHz bandwidth, but real-world performance is closer to 20 MHz with noticeable aliasing artifacts. Budget oscilloscopes are not designed for high-precision measurements, debugging fast digital signals, or detecting short pulses in complex waveforms due to limited bandwidth, lower sample rates, and less advanced triggering options. However, they work well for basic signal visualization, square waves, frequency checks, and amplitude measurements. If you need better build quality, more connectivity, and enhanced usability, the Micsig STO2002 is worth considering. This oscilloscope is almost 4 times as expensive as the Owon or Fnirsi, but it is very reasonably priced for what you get. This 2-channel 200 MHz oscilloscope has advanced measurement capabilities and can be operated via touchscreen, physical buttons or both. With its 8-inch display, Wi-Fi connectivity and remote control options, it feels like using a tablet. If you need a high-end performance handheld oscilloscope and have the budget, the Micsig STO2002 is a major step up from these entry-level models. So, which budget oscilloscope is right for you? Choose the Owon HDS242S if you need more trigger control, a built-in multimeter and function generator, higher bandwidth, a more compact design and increased accuracy for precise measurements. You can choose the Fnirsi 1013D if you need a scope with a big clear display that is simple to control, but with measurements that are not accurate. Thanks for watching. If you find this video helpful, give it a like and don't forget to subscribe for more test equipment comparisons.